Child, tuck yourself in bed and let me tell a story of Lemuria, a long-lost kingdom, and a girl born for glory. In Austria was a crown land ruled by a duke. Aurora was his daughter, child of a duchess mysterious, beloved by her father. He raised the girl alone. They were rarely apart, till the duke felt lonely and misplaced his heart. It was the Great Friday before Easter 1895. Players performed for the duke, his new bride at his side. That night, Aurora went to sleep. The fire burned down low. She caught a chill that spread. Her skin was cold as snow. At dawn, they found her, vacant. Aurora's light gone out. Her father wept and pleaded, but there could be no doubt. For all intents and purposes, Aurora was dead. And yet, once upon a time, she awoke in a strange land instead. Once the sun shone upon a land of sequined valleys and peaks of white, and at night ruined castles glowed with alabaster light. From the stars and the crescent moon, a queen of light ruled this rambling place. Each night she walked the palace alone, her luminosity dawn's own face. Until one night there was no trace. The queen had vanished, and with her the light. Dark resided in its place, the usurper, Umbra, hid from sight. She sent her daughters in her stead, the sun, the stars, and the crescent moon. They pilfered from the sky, extinguished them with the monsoon. Then Umbra's dark creatures conquered the land. Our lives soon snuffed out by a wave of her hand. So Aurora wandered, the twilight forest far from home, starlight only to guide her, except for a firefly alone. Anxious for the comforts of family who could not trace her, searching for the sun and moon, a father to embrace her. And somewhere in the night, perched upon a throne in the dark, waited Umbra, the usurper, to snuff out Aurora's